हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज थर्ड पार्ट इन द चैप्टर एल्डिहाइड्स, कीटोन्स एंड कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड्स। इन आवर प्रीवियस सेशन वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द मेथड्स ऑफ प्रिपरेशन ऑफ एल्डिहाइड्स एंड कीटोन्स। टुडे वी शैल स्टडी देयर फिजिकल एंड केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज। द फर्स्ट इज फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ बोथ एल्डिहाइड्स एंड कीटोन्स। The first physical property is their physical state. So in aldehydes, only the first member, that is formaldehyde, it is a gas. The first aldehyde is a gas. Next, up to 10 members, they are liquids. The first member, aldehyde, that is formaldehyde, is a gas, and the next 10 members are colorless volatile liquids. Whereas in ketones up to 11 members, means up those which contain up to 11 carbon atoms, they are liquids. Means you do not have any gaseous member in ketones. In aldehydes, only formaldehyde is a gas at room temperature, and the next 10 members are colorless volatile liquids. In ketones, those ketones which contain up to 11 carbon atoms, means the starting ketone will be the one which contains 3 carbon atoms. So those which contain up to 11 carbon atoms, they are colorless volatile liquids, and higher members are solids. Then comes our second physical property, which is odor. Lower aldehydes, they have pungent odor. Pungent means irritating odor, a smell or odor which you cannot tolerate, which your nose cannot bear for a long time. That smell is called pungent or irritating odor. So lower aldehydes have pungent and irritating odor, and as the number of carbon atoms increases, this odor becomes less pungent and more fragrant. Means lower aldehydes will have irritating pungent odor, but as you go on with higher members, this pungent odor decreases and fragrant odor increases. In ketones have pleasant odor. For example, your nail polish remover, acetone, you see its smell, it is a pleasant odor. In aldehydes, lower aldehydes have pungent odor. As you move up, the higher members will have fragrant odor, and higher aldehydes will have fruity odor. Higher aldehydes will give you pleasant, fruity, or fragrant odor. Now the third property, solubility. Lower aldehydes like methanol, that is formaldehyde, and ethanol, under ketones, acetone, only these three members are soluble in water. Can you tell why they can be soluble in water? They are soluble in water, they form slight hydrogen bonding with water. So only these three members, lower aldehydes and ketones, that is methanol, ethanol, and acetone, they are soluble in water because they form slight hydrogen bonding with water. But as the number of carbon atoms increases, their solubility decreases. However, they are more soluble in organic solvents like ether, benzene, chloroform, etc. But they are generally insoluble in water. Then who are soluble in water? Only lower members like formaldehyde, acetaldehyde, and acetone. These three members are soluble in water by virtue of their formation of intermolecular hydrogen bonding with water molecules. Rest of the aldehydes and ketones are insoluble in water because they do not form hydrogen bonding. They are, however, soluble in organic solvents like ether, benzene, chloroform, and other solvents. Then, fourth physical property is boiling point. When it comes to boiling point, aldehydes and ketones boiling point is higher than corresponding hydrocarbons and ethers of comparable molecular masses. If you compare an ether and a hydrocarbon with aldehydes and ketones, the boiling point of aldehydes and ketones is higher than them. This is because of dipole interactions, which are not found in ethers and hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbons are non-polar, so obviously their boiling point will be less. Ethers are slightly polar, not more, but they are very slightly polar, as a result of which they will have a slightly higher boiling point than hydrocarbons. But when you compare an ether with aldehydes and ketones are much more polar than ethers. Therefore, their dipole interactions are more. As a result, the boiling point of aldehydes and ketones are higher than hydrocarbons and ethers of comparable molecular masses. But the boiling point of aldehydes and ketones is lesser than alcohols. It is lesser than alcohols because of absence of hydrogen bonding. Because of absence of hydrogen bonding in aldehydes and ketones, or you can say not as much as alcohols have. Alcohols have a greater extent of hydrogen bonding. So for this reason, alcohols will have higher boiling point than aldehydes and ketones. So if I give you an aldehyde and ketone, alcohols, ether, and a hydrocarbon, and if I ask you to arrange them in increasing or decreasing order, so which one will have the highest boiling point? Alcohol. Second comes aldehyde and ether. Third comes alcohols, aldehydes and ketones. Third comes ether, and fourth comes hydrocarbons. A compound which is least polar, which cannot have hydrogen bonding, will have least boiling point. The one which has got highest intermolecular hydrogen bonding, it will have the highest boiling point. For this reason, the boiling point of alcohols is greater than aldehydes and ketones because of presence of intermolecular hydrogen bonding. The boiling point of aldehydes and ketones is greater than hydrocarbons and ethers. It is because of dipole-dipole interactions seen in aldehydes and ketones, as they are polar. The last physical property is density. The density of aldehydes and ketones is lesser than water. The density of aldehydes and ketones is lesser than water. This means they are lighter than water. Then, now we shall study their chemical properties. Under chemical properties, we shall study both aldehydes and ketones together because they show similar properties. The first one is nucleophilic addition reactions. Nucleophilic addition reactions. Before I begin any specific chemical property or chemical reaction, chemical nucleophilic addition reaction, let us understand why aldehydes and ketones show these reactions. Whether it is an aldehyde or ketone, this group is common. Carbonyl group is common. So in this group, say if there is R and here it is H, if it is an aldehyde, we say this group is polar. This group is polar. In this example, oxygen carries partial negative charge and carbon carries partial positive charge. The presence of partial positive charge on carbon attracts nucleophiles. So for this reason, whenever you have a carbonyl group and if it is getting attacked by a nucleophile, what is a nucleophile? A nucleophile is the one which carries negative charge, or it may not carry negative charge, but it is an electron rich species. It has more electrons, extra electrons, surplus electrons. For this reason, nucleophiles are electron rich species. They may or may not carry negative charge. So whenever a negatively charged species attacks a carbonyl compound like aldehyde and ketone, it attacks the carbon atom. As a result, the shared pair of electrons between carbon and oxygen are transferred to oxygen. Therefore, you will have this compound, and O carries now minus charge. Here, our nucleophile gets attached. By mechanism, this step is found to be a slow step. Attack of nucleophile is a slow step. In the second step, this intermediate, which is also called tetrahedral intermediate, it gets now attacked by any positively charged species to neutralize this part. Okay, therefore here was our nucleophile, now it gets attacked by H. This is the common general mechanism of how a nucleophile gets added on to aldehyde or ketone. Let us now see specific reactions. The first addition is addition of hydrogen cyanide. When hydrogen cyanide is added, if this is aldehyde RCH double bond O, if it is reacting with HCN, in your mind you imagine that HCN has already dissociated to give you nucleophile CN minus and H plus. So out of this part, this CN minus should attack carbon, so R C here H as it is, here you will have CN, here single bond, H will go along with oxygen. This product is called cyanohydrin. So whenever hydrogen cyanide is added to either aldehyde or ketone, corresponding cyanohydrins are obtained. Now if this was R, I mean to say, if this was a ketone, the product would have been same, only change is R. Understood? So whether it is an aldehyde or whether it is a ketone, if it reacts with hydrogen cyanide, corresponding cyanohydrins are obtained. You may ask, sir, how should I name the products? For example, if I have CH3CHO, if it is reacting with HCN, then CH3CHOHCN. If you are not able to understand, you split this compound into the correct aldehyde form. So this is product. You may ask, sir, what should I name this compound? You need not remember the IUPAC names while practicing nucleophilic addition reactions of aldehydes and ketones. Even if you remember common names, that is more than enough, which is what is required. Now if this is called acetaldehyde, your product is called acetaldehyde cyanohydrin. That's all. The name along with common name cyanohydrin. If it was acetone, then how will you name? Acetone cyanohydrin. Easier? Now, for this question, you can expect a mechanism in the exam, like explain the mechanism of addition of hydrogen cyanide to aldehyde or ketone. So how do you write? I'll explain you in general form of carbonyl group. In the first step, the carbonyl group gets attacked by cyanide, because in the first step, hydrogen cyanide has dissociated to give us our required nucleophile CN minus. So this is CN minus now attacks carbonyl group. Where should it attack? It attacks carbonyl carbon, because carbonyl carbon is electron deficient. This step is a slow step, which gives rise to intermediate species or tetrahedral intermediate. This again now gets attacked by the second electrophile H plus, and this step is assumed to be a fast step to give us the required product cyanohydrin. If you write only this much part, you will get 3 marks. From here till here, if you write, you will get 3 marks. So this mechanism is important. Explain the mechanism of addition of hydrogen cyanide to aldehyde or ketone. If they ask specifically aldehyde, you write here R, here H. इफ दे आस्क कीटोन रिप्लेस दिस एच बाई आर. इफ द क्वेश्चन इज एक्सप्लेन द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ एडिशन ऑफ एच सी एन टू कार्बोनिल ग्रुप, दिस मच इज एनफ. इफ दे से एक्सप्लेन द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ एडिशन ऑफ एच सी एन हाइड्रोजन साइनाइड टू एनी कार्बोनिल कंपाउंड, चूज एनी कंपाउंड आइदर एल्डिहाइड और कीटोन, इट इज लेफ्ट टू यू. सो दिस शुड बी द मैकेनिज्म. नाउ वंस वेन एच सी एन इज ओवर, यू हैव सेकेंड एडिशन. द सेकेंड एडिशन इज एडिशन ऑफ सोडियम बाइसल्फाइट, एडिशन ऑफ सोडियम बाइसल्फाइट. इन दिस रिएक्शन अगेन टेक सेम कंपाउंड, आई विल चूज एल्डिहाइड, यू कैन राइट कीटोन ऑल्सो. वेन दिस रिएक्ट्स विथ NaHSO3, फर्स्ट यू राइट दीज पार्ट्स कॉमन. ओके, मेक दीज पार्ट्स कॉमन, आउट ऑफ दिस सेपरेट दिस हेच, अटैच इट विथ ऑक्सीजन, देन रिमेनिंग पार्ट बिगिन विथ सल्फर SO3 Na. दिस शुड बी अवर प्रोडक्ट. वॉट डू आई नेम सर? दिस कंपाउंड इज कॉल्ड सोडियम बाइसल्फाइट. इफ इट इज एन अल्डिहाइड, अल्डिहाइड बाइसल्फाइट, अल्डिहाइड सोडियम बाइसल्फाइट एज द प्रोडक्ट. इफ इट इज कीटोन, कीटोन सोडियम बाइसल्फाइट, दैट्स ऑल. देन थर्ड वी हैव एडिशन ऑफ ग्रिग्नार्ड रिएजेंट्स. यू हैव करेस्पॉन्डिंग सोडियम बाइसल्फाइट एडिशन कंपाउंड इन द सेकेंड रिएक्शन. नाउ इन द थर्ड रिएक्शन यू हैव एडिशन ऑफ ग्रिग्नार्ड रिएजेंट्स. हाउ डू यू कैरी आउट एडिशन ऑफ ग्रिग्नार्ड रिएजेंट्स? रिएक्ट एन अल्डिहाइड विथ ग्रिग्नार्ड रिएजेंट इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ ड्राई ईथर. इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ ड्राई ईथर रिएक्ट ग्रिग्नार्ड रिएजेंट. ट्रांसफर दिस आर पार्ट टू कार्बन एंड रिमेनिंग MgX पार्ट टू ऑक्सीजन. सो वॉट विल यू राइट? RCH, हियर R, हियर O, MgX. दिस इज एन एडिशन प्रोडक्ट, सो इट इज कॉल्ड अडक्ट. हाइड्रोलाइज दिस बाय वाटर इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ एन एसिड, हियर H हियर OH हियर. सो यू विल हैव माइनस ऑफ MgOHX. दिस पार्ट इज गॉन. वॉट इज लेफ्ट? RCROH, here also H. Now this is one general reaction. If this R is replaced by formaldehyde and if it is reacted with a Grignard reagent, then you will end up with the primary alcohol. Here the product is alcohol. Whenever Grignard reagents are added to either aldehydes or ketones, you will get corresponding alcohols. How do you get corresponding alcohols? In the first step, Grignard reagent attacks the carbon atom of aldehyde or ketone to form an adduct, addition product, which further hydrolyzes to give you corresponding alcohol. Remember, if you have chosen aldehyde, that too, if you have chosen formaldehyde, only then you will get primary alcohol. Other than formaldehyde, you choose any aldehyde, you will get secondary alcohol. And if you have chosen ketone, then you will get tertiary alcohol. You will get tertiary alcohol. So addition of Grignard reagents to aldehydes gives you either primary or secondary alcohol. Now, which aldehyde gives you primary alcohol? It is formaldehyde. Other than formaldehyde, you choose any aldehyde, it will give you secondary alcohols. Then, finally, when ketones are made to react with Grignard reagents, they will give you tertiary alcohols. Now, these were three addition reactions. Then, we have fourth addition. It is addition of alcohol itself. Addition of alcohols. Under addition of alcohols, we have only two general reactions. One is with respect to aldehyde and the other with respect to ketone. You need not remember any specific examples. Choose an aldehyde when it is reacted with a monohydric alcohol. Monohydric alcohol means it is the one which contains one hydroxyl group in it. Whenever aldehyde reacts with monohydric alcohol in the presence of dry HCl gas. This is one condition. So you separate H, attach it to oxygen and remaining alkoxy group to carbon. How will you write? R C H, here OH, here O R dash. This compound is called hemiacetal. Hemiacetal or alkoxy alcohol. Alkoxy alcohol. It is also called alkoxy alcohol. This again reacts with one more molecule of primary alcohol or monohydric alcohol under the same condition, dry HCl gas. This time you remove water. The same part is replaced here. R C H O R dash. Here also O R dash. This is called gem dialkoxy compound. You may ask, why gem? Because two alkoxy groups are attached to same carbon, therefore it is geminal. Two alkoxy groups are there, therefore dialkoxy. Geminal dialkoxy compound, commonly called as acetal. How do you convert a given aldehyde into acetal? By reacting it with monohydric alcohol in the presence of dry HCl gas. In the first step, it will give you a hemiacetal or alkoxy alcohol, which again reacts with a molecule of monohydric alcohol to give you geminal dialkoxy compound, which is otherwise called acetal. If a ketone is chosen, R C R double bond O, and if it is made to react with a dihydric alcohol, especially ethylene glycol. How do you write ethylene glycol? CH2 CH2 OH OH. I'll simply change the pattern of writing. You see, it is same ethylene glycol, OH, CH2, CH2, OH. Okay. It is also made to react under the same condition, dry HCl gas. Then what happens? Eliminate this part. You eliminate this much part. So if water is gone, what will be left? R, C, R as it is. Instead of oxygen, you will now have this oxygen. Here this oxygen, they are bonded with methylene groups or CH2 groups. Now this became a cyclic structure. This compound is called cyclic ketals or ethylene glycol ketal. Whenever ketones react with ethylene glycol in the presence of dry HCl gas, you will get cyclic ketals, which are otherwise called ethylene glycol ketals. This reaction is not so important from exam point of view. Then we have fifth addition, addition of ammonia and its derivatives. Addition of ammonia and its derivatives. This can be a more trickiest part in this chapter because ammonia and their derivatives are many. Remembering them is important. Let us begin with ammonia only. So under fifth part, we have A, addition of ammonia. You choose first either an aldehyde or ketone. I'll choose aldehyde. Okay, it is reacting with ammonia. How do you write ammonia formula? NH3. Now out of this, I'll remove two hydrogens. Can I write in this way? Because this also NH3 is same. So whenever ammonia reacts with aldehyde or ketone, water goes away. A molecule of water is lost to give you RCH double bond NH. This product is called imine. Whenever aldehyde or ketone reacts with ammonia, corresponding imines are obtained. If this was R, the other was also R. If it is ketone, the product is ketone imine. If it is an aldehyde, aldehyde imine or aldimine. If you take aldehyde, aldimine. If you take ketone, ketimine. Under the same, you got imine as product. If you have a primary amine, from ammonia you replace one hydrogen by an alkyl group. Keep this part common, RCHO plus RNH2. This is a primary amine. In this case, again remove water. What will you be left with? RCH double bond NR. This is called substituted imines. If you take ammonia, you will get imine. If you take primary amine, you will get substituted amine. Then third time, addition of hydroxylamine. How do you write this reaction? Same, RCHO plus NH2OH. This is hydroxylamine. Again eliminate water. You will have RCH double bond NOH. It is called oxime. I am writing the reactions only for aldehyde. You need to practice these reactions for at least a minimum of 3 different aldehydes and a minimum of 3 different ketones. So when I write only one this reaction, below this you should try for formaldehyde, acetaldehyde and benzaldehyde, 3 compounds. Similarly, under ketones, general reaction for ketone, then acetone and then acetophenone. At least 5 to 6 reactions you need to practice in order to remember. Now after hydroxylamine, you have hydrazine, addition of NH2-NH2. This is called hydrazine. Reaction RCHO plus NH2-NH2. Eliminate water. You will be having RCH double bond N-NH2. If you have taken hydrazine, you will have product hydrazone, corresponding hydrazones. Then next is you have phenylhydrazine. Under the same hydrazine, you replace one hydrogen. So you have phenylhydrazine, RCHO plus NH2, NH and benzene ring. What will you get? Same removal of water and then RCH double bond N, single bond NH, and this compound is called phenylhydrazone. If you have chosen hydrazine, the product will be hydrazone. Because you have chosen phenylhydrazine, your product will be phenylhydrazone. How many are over? 5 are over. Then two more. The next one is यू हैव दिस कंपाउंड दिस कंपाउंड इज कॉल्ड 2,4 डाइनाइट्रो फिनाइल हाइड्रजीन इट इज कॉल्ड 2,4 डाइनाइट्रो फिनाइल हाइड्रजीन और सिंपली 2,4 DNPH और 2,4 DNP some books give it as 2,4 DNP if this is reacted with aldehyde or ketone this is reacted with aldehyde or ketone again removal of water what product is left RCH double bond N single bond NH dash benzene ring here NO2 again at fourth position NO2 it is 2,4 DNPH 2,4 dinitrophenyl hydrazone 2,4 dinitrophenyl hydrazone is obtained then next reaction under same addition of ammonia and its derivatives we have the last reaction of addition of semicarbazide how do you write semicarbazide NH2NH CONH2 this is semicarbazide for the sake of convenience I'll shift this hydrogen on the other side eliminate water you will be left with RCH double bond N NHCONH2 this compound is called semicarbazone so there are 7 addition reactions of ammonia 1 ammonia primary amine hydroxylamine hydrazine phenyl hydrazine 2,4 dinitrophenyl hydrazine and semicarbazide. Today we have studied only nucleophilic addition reactions of aldehydes and ketones. In our next class, we shall study the other chemical properties and other reactions of aldehydes and ketones. Thank you.